And talking a little bit about the draft, I know some of the mock drafts have tied you to the Patriots, potentially as a Gronk replacement. What do you think of that fit?
I mean, obviously, that'd be awesome. I mean, I'm a, I grew up watching Gronk, and, you know, as a guy that I try and model my game after, but, you know, obviously, that'd be a lot of fun, and, you know, hopefully that can happen. I mean, in high school, I wore 87 because of Gronk, and, like, you know, that's kind
of... Are you serious? That's so funny.
So, like, that's, like, you know, he's a guy that I looked up to and stuff, so, I mean, definitely, he's a guy that I've always watched and, you know, just really looked after.
So, I guess I want to talk a little bit about the tight end position. I feel like, compared to a lot of other skill positions, tight end is one of those where it's very rare to see one go in the first round, and especially with the Super Bowl, you had two teams that had complete tight ends this past year. Do you feel like that at all is going to make a difference in this year's draft?
I mean, I would hope so. I mean, I would hope that team maybe would think, yeah, let's go take a tight end a little bit earlier than they normally would. That obviously benefit me a lot. But, you know, I think you know, you look at the past couple of years, whether it's Gronk, Kelce, or Kittle, like, There's always a tight end on the Super Bowl teams that, you know, they just have good tight ends, and like it seems like that's how teams are able to get to the Super Bowl. So, you know, that's just a key piece and everything. So I think teams are realizing that, and I think that, you know, brings a lot of value to my position.
Yeah, and I think compared to wide receivers and running backs, tight end is one of those positions that takes a while for people to get their full potential in the NFL, whereas, you know, wide receivers, running backs, you can kind of plug and play right away. Why do you think that is? And do you think there's a larger learning curve when it comes to the tight end position?
I think there's for two reasons. I think one, because of the physicality, you know, I think it's, you know, it's a different physicality from college to pros, just because of, you know, dealing with bigger guys, faster guys when you're blocking and stuff like that. And then mentally, you just have to know everything. It's, I think it's this, you know, after the quarterback, probably the next position that has to know everything on the field. So, kind of have to know all that stuff. So I think both physically and mentally, there's a learning curve that goes into it, and that's kind of why you kind of see guys, you know, maybe the first year they're you know, not jumping into it right away, but then, you know, as the second, third year comes, that they really start to excel in the league.
Yeah. Is there a certain quarterback you'd like to catch passes from?
Yeah, I mean, growing up, I was always, like, you know, obviously watching Gronk. I always watched Brady. He was the guy that I watched, you know, since I was a little kid.
You're a Patriots fan, all right.
Yeah, that'd be kind of a dream of mine to, you know, catch a pass from Tom Brady, so that'd be pretty cool.
So that was the team you wanted to play for growing up, you'd say?
Well, I always rooted for them, but I grew up in Chicago, so I was always a big Bears fan. So, like, you know, I always stuck with my Bears.
gotcha. So I know you're here on behalf of Gillette. So what are you doing with Gillette for the draft?
Yeah, so Gillette, they've done something really cool that they're kind of putting on for us. You know, with us not being able to go to Vegas and all that, they kind of did this virtual draft deal. So, you know, they're kind of helping us along with that, kind of making this experience a lot of fun, you know. Mm-hmm. So this virtual, you know, red carpet draft, kind of, you know, making sure we look good and all that type of stuff and saving and all that. And then, you guys, you know, people can follow it with the hashtag NFL Draft Red Carpet. And you can follow both my Twitter and Instagram accounts, both at Cole Kmet, and then also follow the NFL Twitter account for more on it.
I love that. So are you going to, like, come in with a red suit?
I'm going more casual. You'll have to check it out, but I'm going more casual. So, you know, I'm going to be more casual. That's kind of what I was planning on doing anyways, was kind of being at home. So it's kind of meshing the two together, which is pretty cool. But, I'm going to be more casual. I'm not going to be that flashy with the suits and all that.
Business up top and, you know, sleeping on the bottom.
Yeah, probably.